Let me summarize the topics of today's lecture. There are three important characteristics that we're going to cover. The first is Maxwell's equations. We've studied Maxwell's equations in both the time domain and the frequency domain. It's easy to go back and forth between these two different forms, and you may need to. A general region means that there may be sources such as conductivity, charge, and conduction current, or we can derive the equations for a source-free region such as air. The wave equation is then derived from Maxwell's equations. We can go to the wave equation. The textbook derives this for the time domain, so please take a look at your text. We derived it in this lecture for the frequency domain, and what we did was went from coupled first-order differential Maxwell's equations to a single second-order differential equation, which represents the wave. We did that for both for the electric field. You can similarly do it for the magnetic field. We also compared these to the transmission line equations. Finally, we went to plane waves. Plane waves are a special case of the wave equation. We could have done plane waves, or we could have done spherical waves, or we could have done any other form of wave with the wave equation, but in this class we're now going to concentrate on plane waves. With plane waves, we talked about a direction of propagation and how that relates to the electric and magnetic field polarization, or the direction of the vectors of the electric and magnetic field. We also talked about the propagation. The complex propagation constant gamma is equal to the attenuation constant alpha plus J times the propagation constant, not the complex propagation constant, just the scalar propagation constant beta, and how that also relates to the characteristic impedance eta. Then we looked at how we can convert electric fields to magnetic fields, and I'm assuming you go back the other direction. This could be done in both the time domain and the frequency domain. So the topics of today's lecture are able to help us understand how a plane wave propagates in space, and we defined a plane wave as having both positive and negative going pieces, just like we did when we were doing the transmission line equations. I bet you can guess what we're going to be doing in the next lecture, and that's going to be reflections of plane waves.